Welcome back to Bears Blend, people. Today, we have another whiskey review. If you don't know me, well, pleasure to meet you. I am God. I'm actually Ronald. I'm no God. So, that yeah, okay. I don't know where I was going with that one, but today we have a special bottle here on my desk. It's a 12-year-old Glendronach. Or is it 12 years old? In fact, it's not. This one is 18 years old. Huh? It says 12 on the label, Ronald. You're drunk. No, I'm not, mates. This one was bottled in 2013. I have a link in the description of this video to a whole... Now, it's not that big, but... a blog type of thing, an article, that's the word, about the whole age statement thing with Glendronach, because Glendronach was shut down from 1969 until 2001. That's a 6-year gap, and well, the whiskies who are distilled before that gap, if I understand it right, are actually older. Some 6 years, some not. The 18 years old that I have in my storage at the moment, the one you saw with last unboxing video, is actually 21 years old. Because, how do I know? That's the funny thing. I will get the bottle out shortly. It actually has a bottling date on the bottle. The reason I got this one is because it said on the like advertisement that this is the 2013 bottling. I could also get a 2015 and a 16, I believe. This one was a little bit more expensive, but it's an 18-year-old whiskey. Glendronach also doesn't color their whiskey, doesn't chill filter the whiskey. This one is at 46 or 43 ABV. I will check in a moment. So you actually are getting pretty insane value for money, even if it was just a 12-year-old. The normal 12 years old is 30 to 35 euros. That's really good. And this one is 40, I believe. At least where I got it. The normal 12 years old was 30. It had a discount of a couple euros, so it was a bit cheaper. But this is actually an 18-year-old whiskey. So if I like this, I will buy another one. I also read about the 15-year-old. And that one is 21 years as well, because they have a shortage and blah. It is getting re-released in 2018, so I will definitely buy one of those. I cannot buy a whole bunch at one in one buy. Kind of sad, because they have limited it on the site where I buy my whiskey, so I have to buy them in batches. But I will definitely get a collection of this one, the Allardyce The Allardyce is the 18-year-old. The what do you call it? The 15-year-old revival. That one is expensive. It's 58 euros. So I will get that. Maybe I will get another one in the next couple. I don't know. It's expensive. So I will either just keep it for drinking, or I will sell it on, because those whiskies are getting insane value in a couple of years. Let me tell you that, my mates. Whiskies which have that kind of thing to them, the price over 9,000, not really, but those will get valuable. So I will definitely invest in those ones. But I will just also invest in this one, because I will be drinking this one, because the value is insane. So, let me open the container for you. Well, first let's check out the container. It's kind of nice. Glendronach was founded in the beginning of the 19th century, 1826. Founded in 1826. James Maldice. Can you read this? I cannot. It's horrible. Why do you do this? Balanced, smooth, creamy. Yeah, okay, the basic stuff. Matured in a combination of the finest Perro Jimenez and Oloroso sherry casks. Perro Jimenez sherry casks are a little sweeter, and Oloroso are a little bit deeper of a sherry. So, Highland Single Malt Scotch Whisky. Non-chill filtered, natural color, that's the way I like it. Product of Scotland. Looks all fine and dandy to me. Appearance deep amber, red gold. Okay. Let me get out the bottle. But Glendronic is definitely a whiskey I will be collecting. For drinking and just for the pure collect type of thing. So, deep amber, red gold. Yeah, I am even saying it's a little bit darker. Light mahogany? Yeah, sure. Let me get you the bottle. There it is. Hope you can see it with the lighting. The color is amazing on this one. I actually compared the color of this one to the 18-year-old and the 21-year-old in my unboxing whiskey haul video. Check it out. Sweet creamy vanilla with hints of ginger and autumn fruits. Sure. The palate, rich creamy silky smooth, warm rich oak and sherry sweetness. Full mouthfeel, resin, soft root, spicy with medium length and a dry finish. Sounds good for the price, doesn't it? Finish long, full and firm, slightly nutty. With this whiskey, I am just like mouth watering for the price and the quality that I'm getting. Try to find a 12-year-old, let's forget the whole 18-year-old thing, a 12-year-old whiskey, yeah? Which one has been non-chill filtered, a sherry whiskey. Non-chill filtered, natural color for 30 euros. There's not a lot out there. There is another one, Glen. I don't know what it's called, but they own Glendronic actually. Not Glenlivet, not Glengoyne, not Glenfiddich. Why is every single whiskey beginning with the word Glen? I don't get it. No, I cannot. They also have a huge whiskey range. Age statement, non-age statement, they actually own this one. But they do a lot with Perro Jimenez sherry. And a lot of people say this one is actually better. The normal 12 years old, not the 18 years old. Glendronic Distillery is in the Fork Valley in Aberdeenshire. Is named after the source of its water, the Dronic Burn. Okay. It has a history of enterprising owners from the flamboyant James Allardyce. Oh, they named the whiskey after him, good. To the ambitious Walter Scott, he didn't got a whiskey. Oh, sad. Although times have moved on, the process used to create the Glendronic have remained largely unchanged. That's good. Today's malt is creating using great Oregon pine wash bags and the same shaped stills used in 1826. It's stilled and matured and bottled by the proprietors, the Glendronic Distillery. Nice. 700 milliliters, of course, 43 ABV, so not really high, but 43 for me is kind of the sweet spot. So, let's open this one. I will definitely be ordering another one in the coming week, and maybe even another one, if I like it a lot, because I will be drinking this if I like it a lot. But I also want to keep one for, just to see what the value does, because... Well, I gotta, you see, whiskey costs money, and I wanna like enhance my whiskey collection with whiskeys that I maybe flip for some money. That seems like a nice idea to me. Cork, let's pop it open, shall we? Oh, delicious sound. Sherry. Is this a natural cork? I don't think so. Who gives a shit? Ah, lovely. You can already sense the Perro Jimenez sherry influence. It's like that sweet sherry. I'm curious what the age has done to this one. Not too much. Not too much. Definitely not too much. Because it's not evening. And I have to do some other things today. So, keeping the thing on. Yeah. Keep it in the picture. Perfect. color, natural, nice, just the color that you expect from a nice whiskey. I may be getting another whiskey glass. I like this one, but I may be getting a really good nosing glass type of thing. Oh, this one is good. This one is so good. The thing with aged whiskies, especially 16 years and above, sometimes, and most of the time with 18 years old and stuff, you have to let them sit for a minute. Because, well, they need a little bit of breathing room to really open up. And I'm sensing that with this one. The first thing what I get when smelling this whiskey is Pedro Ximénez sherry. And that's all. I may be getting some raisins, some oak, some cask influence. Yes, it is definitely in there. Now the dark fruits are coming. Really pleasant nose. Just a nice sherry whiskey nose. Just nice. Do they have bourbon casks in here? No, don't think so. Maybe those sherry casks are from American oak. Don't know. But I am getting some honey and vanilla notes, but it's in the back. It's not as in front as the sherry. It definitely has complexity to it. I can sense some dried fruits. Maybe even that cooked fruit note, if you know what I mean. Yeah, resins and wood influence, it's in there. Nice. You can tell if whiskey is older that the oak is more prominent in a whiskey. Because the longer a whiskey gets in a cask, stays in a cask, the more influence the cask will have on a whiskey. And the tannins and the oak will shine through in the whiskey. And I'm definitely getting some tannins, but not too much. The sherry marks those bitter tannins a little bit and makes them a little sweeter. But I can definitely tell with the nose that this whiskey is older. It's actually similar to my Glenfiddich, 18 years old, special reserve, blah, 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 which is twice the price of this one. I got it for a little cheaper, but normally it's twice the price of this one. And I know which I would buy, this one. Because this one has got a little bit better complexity to it. It is 43% instead of 40, natural color. And not chill filtered. And the Glenfiddich is all of that. Still a really good whiskey though. But can't beat this price to value. I don't know how the normal 12 years old bottling is. I may buy that one just to see. But who knows. Yeah, now it is opening up. Now I can definitely sense some more fruits. A little bit of strawberry in there. Maybe some dried fig. Some dried plums. Those really nice sherry type of fruit whiskeys. Not getting actual cherries though. It is really pleasant. But it needs time to open up a bit. I think this whiskey will be at its best around 15-18 minutes in. But I don't really have the time for that one. I just want to see how good it is. And then order like 15 boxes of it. I can't sadly. Because they put a limit on one per order. Thanks. Yeah, there is a little bit of the caramel vanilla holly note that I notice around bourbon cask whiskies, but it's in the back and on top of it. So if you get some a little further away from the glass, you definitely start noticing that more sweet note. But it is really nicely balanced. I don't like Pedro Ximénez sherry at its own. But the combination between Oloroso and Pedro Ximénez, sometimes Oloroso can even like be a little bit on the hard side, on the deep side for my taste and my smell. But this one is perfectly balanced. This is a really good whiskey. If you can get your hands on a 13-year-old bottling of Glendronach 12-year-old, get it. Get it. Please get it. But after I'm done buying all of them. The finish is really good on this one. This has a really good finish. One of the best finishes I've ever tasted. I was just reading a little bit about the tasting notes that were on the bottle. And I am... Yeah, there is a little bit of spice in the nose. But I think I'm not getting all of it because it has to open up a bit. So, when you let it sit for a minute, the taste... The aftertaste, it's one of the best. It is a gem, this one. It's a gem of a whiskey. I will definitely order 5 of these if I had the chance. They are so goddamn good. Okay, control yourself. But yeah, if I let it open up a little bit, I will definitely get more of the spices, the ginger. I can sense it in there, but it's hiding. Maybe even a drop of water, what... would do it good, but I'm not really a whiskey water type person. I may experiment with some whiskeys, but I don't know. Yeah, the spiciness is coming through a little bit. It is coming through. It's not all there yet, but it's there. But okay, enough of the nose. The nose needs to open up a bit. Okay. But that's just a matter of time. It's better now than when I poured. And remember, the first glass of whiskey is in fact the least it's not the best glass you will get of the whiskey. After you get more of the liquid out of the bottle, some more air will get into it, and there will be oxidization, which will in time enhance your whiskey. So if you get a whiskey, and especially the peaty ones, and you don't like them with the first glass, no problem. Leave it, come back for it. Come back for it in like a couple days, a week, maybe 2 weeks. I have had it with my Lagavulin. The first couple glasses were really hefty, and I let it sit. And then I came back to it a couple weeks later, and I was like, oh my god, this has really changed in such an awesome whiskey. It's more mellow, it's more rounded, it's kind of like a Pokemon. The first glass is like the baby Squirtle type Pokemon. It's nice, but what you gotta do with it? Then, well, you let it sit for a minute, it opens up, some air gets into the bottle, it settles down. You get like the mid version, like the war turtle, you know what I mean? And then when you, well, really let the oxidization take place, really letting open up the whiskey, then you get the Blastoise, and then it's like the full picture, and like, yes! And well, that's with this whiskey, and I am not disappointed with my first glass, but I still have this nice, dark, even Christmas type of fruit aftertaste. I have never experienced this. This is really nice. I can sense some spices, some fruits. It's really hard to pin down, actually. This is such a complex whiskey. This is definitely 18 years old. This is definitely an 18-year-old bottling. So if you're like, I don't know if it's true because, well, this still says 12 and not 18. It's 18 years old. I have a lot of whiskeys. I have sherry whiskeys, which are 12 years old. I have sherry whiskeys that are 18 years old. And this one beats a lot of the 18-year-old sherry whiskeys. Because it's so complex. Now I'm definitely getting the ginger. Yeah, the spices are coming. Yes, it needs a little bit of time to open up. No alcohol burn at all. You get some spiciness of the casks, the cask influence, the oak. It is there just at the side of your mouth, not overpowering. It is so pleasant. The aftertaste, the whole mouthfeel, it's creamy, it's not oily, it's not watery, it is full, it is rich, it is goddamn perfect. This is the favorite whiskey that I own, and I own whiskeys that are expensive as hell. But this one is my favorite. It is my gem. I will definitely get a supply of this one because this will be my main whiskey until I get better ones. And I am searching for like a main whiskey, but the price of this, 40. And I am even thinking the normal 12 years old is also really good. I cannot wait to try the 18-year-old, which is in fact 21 years old, and a normal 21 years old. And the thing with that graph is that it's posted in the description down below, by the way. It's a link to an article. They say that the 18-year-old, the actual 18-year-old, and the 21-year-old will actually get older in the next couple of years because they still have batches and stuff, and they still use the casks that they filled before shutting down in well, the really early 2000s and 20th century, 1969 to 2001. Those are the time spans that I was looking for. I cannot wait to try them. Glendronach is my favorite distillery from now on. It's just awesome. Just natural color, pur naturel. It's just amazing. If you can get your hands on this one, even if it's the normal 12-year-old, I would suggest just try them. Just try them. They're amazing. This one is amazing. It's such a good whiskey. I will not be opening the 21 years old and 18 years old for a little while. I think I might actually buy a couple more of the 15. The 15 years old is really expensive, but I will definitely buy the 15 years old. I will definitely buy another 18-year-old because it's on discount at the moment. But I don't think... Well, the 18-year-old gets older in a couple of years. So I think I will be just leaving that one. But I will definitely buy a couple more of these because these ones will run out. Same goes with the 15. So if you're wondering which Glendronach to get now, it's this one and 15. 15 is expensive. 58 euros, but I think it's worth it. I think, because it is a 21-year-old whiskey, and a lot of people say it's the best one in the range. So, I will try it. Or I will just keep it shut and just see what the prices do, and if it's like worth 300, I will just, yeah, take my money, go, because I like this one. Who knows? We will see what happens. The nose is developing in such a lovely way. I don't think this one needs water, actually. This one just opens up with a thing called time. And that's a thing a lot of people don't give whiskey time. You have a lot of people open a bottle, straight into the glass, just drink it, say, oh, it's nice, little sherry, little this, little that. Whiskey needs time, especially the older ones. 16 years and up, it needs time. A minute in the glass for a year in the cask. That's kind of the rule. And, well, a second in your mouth for a year in the cask. That's also a thing. It just depends on what you like. And if the whiskey is really intense, then you cannot keep it in your mouth for that long. But this one, definitely, you can definitely explore this one in your mouth. It's such an awesome whiskey. The finish is amazing. I still have this aftertaste in my mouth. I still have this lovely aftertaste. And this nice mouthfeel. It's amazing. It's just a nice... that finish. Perfect. 10 out of 10. Cannot get any better. For sure. I will be reviewing the normal draft result. Because I think... No, well... I just want to see what that one is like. And if there is a really big difference. Because they're all from the same family. And, well, I just want to see how different are they. Are they good? Well, of course. But what's the distillery character like? What has the age done to it? The cask maturation. I think the 21 years old is solo matured in Peru Jimenez. I don't know that exactly, but I have to check. But this one, definitely my favorite. This one will get a nice place somewhere to be enjoyed really, really quickly. And I have to stock up on these ones because it will be so sad when they're all gone. The 2013 bottlings. It will be so sad when they're gone. This is a whiskey like it was supposed to be, you know. Just perfect in every single way. I'm not giving it... You see how my ratings work? I am rating the whiskey as a whole. What good have they done better? Is it a good one for the price? I'm not giving it numbers or figures or scores for what I have tasted. I'm giving it for the quality of the whiskey on its own. Sure, I might have some better ones than some other few. This one is the best I have. One of the best. One of the top three. For sure, because I really like Macallan Sienna as well. And that one is really intense. I like that a lot. But then you might say, well, I don't have all those whiskeys, but I really like this one. I love it. Then it's just a 10. Because then, if a whiskey is good as it is, it has a good finish, a good nose, good mouthfeel. It's not colored. It's non-chill filtered. It's just good all around. Then it's just a 10 out of 10. Then they couldn't have done a better job. And I am going to start going down with the scores if the color is not natural and it has been chill filtered. Why not the ABV? Because some whiskies go well with higher ABV, some go with lower ABVs. It's just the way it goes. But I just want normal whiskies. Forget the chill filtration. Forget the color. Color is I may go like down half a point on some scores because the coloration doesn't really take away the sensation. Yeah, visual sensation, but taste and no sensation, no. Chill filtration, it could do that. I don't have experience with it. And before I'm going to say, yeah, chill filtration does this and this and this. It does certain things, but I cannot say how that impacts the whiskey. Because I haven't tried the same whiskey with or without chill filtration. I haven't, so I'm not going to say that. Only thing I'm saying is they can lose it. Because in my opinion, it could make a difference. Because they take something out of it. That's that. Chocolate. There is this thing which I couldn't put my nose on very well. And it's chocolate. And most of the time when you empty a glass, you let it sit for a couple minutes, even a couple of hours, you will get a chocolate note. And then, yes, you will know what it is. And I know what it is. Chocolate. There is some dark chocolate. Not bitter dark chocolate. There is no bitterness at all. No alcohol burn at all. It's perfect in every single way. But chocolate. That's the thing that I... Yeah, there is some dark chocolate with a little bit of milk chocolate. It's kind of sweet, not sour. Yeah, perfect. I'm not sensing any oranges or something. It's really those autumn fruits, those dark fruits. But it's the pleasant dark fruits, not those hard and dark and deep. It's those mixed with Peru Jimenez, actually. So it's really nice and enjoyable. And, well, I am not burning a hole in my wallet after drinking a bottle, because this is only 40 euros. So, yes, I will definitely buy a couple more and definitely go to this as my main drinking whiskey when I just want to enjoy a good whiskey without seeing the money just flow down the drain. Because a couple whiskeys are really expensive that I own. And I am almost scared to drink because, yeah, I find it a little bit of a waste. But this one, perfect find by me. 10 out of 10, would recommend. People, guys, girls, aliens, I don't know. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave it a thumbs up if you did. Definitely go get yourself a 2013 bottling. That's important. You can see the bottling date, by the way, on the back. You can't see it, but it's here. It's here. Just keep it in the light and you can see through it. 2013-07-11. Then that's when it's bottled. A couple days before my birthday, actually. 11th of July. I am... my birthday was on the 26th of July. But people, thank you for watching this video. It's a long one, but it deserves a long video. I will head off now and I will talk to you later. Goodbye.